It's your Mad Real director, Chris Moss, and welcome to the non-spoiler review of Joker. My prediction was right. If you haven't checked out my Joker prediction, card is up above. I give it an A+. It's my favorite film of the year. And yes, even over Endgame, only because to me, Endgame was great. But, you know, after 10 years of movies, this, you know, we got to build up over 10 years. But Joker, this was a one and done deal, even though there's rumors of a possible sequel. But still, straight out of the gate, this, I don't know, DC did their thing with this movie. So that's why I put it over Endgame. But Endgame is number two for me. I don't really want to give spoilers, so I'm not going to really go into, you know, the movie too much. I'm going to try to keep it brief and say Phoenix killed it as Joker. The supporting cast killed it. Robert De Niro. It's just the movie, the pace is well done. The tone is well done from beginning to end. The cinematography, everything is so well done. And I know people are comparing Phoenix to Heath Ledger. And as I said on my Instagram page, I truly believe you can't compare the two, because trying to compare Heath Ledger's Joker against Phoenix's Joker is like trying to compare Michael Jackson and Prince. They're two titans in the game. They're undeniably amazing and talented, but it comes down to preference, really. Like, you can't, I mean, some people can, but for me personally, to me, they're even, you know what I'm saying? I would say I'll prefer Ledger's if I had to pick. I give Ledger the slight edge only because we got to see him in full-blown Joker mode for like 30, 35 minutes out of a two-hour movie. Whereas Phoenix, we only see him as full-blown Joker for maybe 5 to 10 minutes, you know? So I wanted to see more. If there is a con in this movie, which I wouldn't even consider this a con, it's more of a nitpick, I would have liked to see him in full-blown Joker mode for more than 5 to 10 minutes, but it's an origin story, quote unquote. And like I said, I don't want to get into it too much and, you know, accidentally give spoilers. But yeah, believe the hype. He better get at least the Oscar nomination. Go see it. The less you know going into this movie, the better. It's a movie that definitely sticks with you. It's not as violent as most people are hyping it up to be. It doesn't really get violent until like the last maybe 10 minutes of the movie. But yeah, I mean, if you can watch John Wick and any Tarantino film, you'll be fine with this one. It's not that serious. Oh, and I hear that even though most of the Oscar voters, the people who vote for which movies get nominated for the Oscars, most of them liked it. But I'm also seeing that some of them are refusing to go see it, which bothers me, because it's like, if you're on a committee who votes for movies, you're obligated to go see a movie. Like, if you're refusing to go see Joker, then I hope you're not allowed to vote for whether or not Joker gets nominated and or wins, because then that's not fair for you to come out and say, I'm not going to go see this movie because they're glorifying mental illness, which the movie is not. Go into this movie with an open mind and form your own opinion. But yeah, I'm not liking the whole Oscar voters. Some of them, not most of them, like it, but you know, you have some that are just like, I'm not going to go see this movie, because then you shouldn't be allowed to vote. And I hope, I don't know the rules of voting in the Oscars, but I hope they are not allowed to vote. But anyway, that's a movie for another time. So yeah, go check Joker out. Believe the hype. There is comedy moments in here, and the comedy lands. It sticks the landing. It's actually funny. It's a movie that sticks with you. And, you know, as a huge Joker fan, I greatly appreciate this movie. Love this movie. Go see it. Thank you for watching. Thank you for the support. And remember, put on a happy face.